All right, we are ready for round one on the play. And yeah, keep it. I don't know if I want to draw two cards on turn two. It depends on what I draw, if I need to cast something. If my turn is just pass, can probably do that. My mana base worked out perfectly. Godless Shrine. I drew Baldur's Skull, which can let me know what to waste the Findern Elf. Even though, yeah, I don't wanna pop it just yet. Can wait for, let's see, for when I draw. So Urborg, Awakening Zone, there it is. Just gonna attack here and cast Awakening Zone. Then start my engine. No. Okay. Let's see how does it deal with my powerful combo with this black-white mid-range deck. Oblivion Ring, so he dealt with that. Unfortunately, I can't grudge that. Okay, he chose to take the Awakening Zone rather than the Skull Clamp. And I'm just gonna cast his Baldur's Skull that I saved the Findern for. And hope that his deck with creature can't really deal with this. Let's see. My hand is not that good to deal with a powerful creature like the Crescent Demon. No, I don't wanna. Thank you. Maniac Vandal isn't a good draw. I think I will draw two cards off of it. Okay. Those aren't the worst. Can actually how do I deal with that card? With Desecration Demon, I mean. Can Flameton Cavo plus the Punishing Fire in my hand? Can just think equip Baldur's Skull to a bigger stuff and race for him. I can also here equip the Germ and attack. It's a gain 5, draw 2. Think is enough actually. And then I'm just gonna go Caryatid equip. Let's see. I think the attack ER is okay. Since if he blocks, I'm just gonna Punishing Fire that. I'm sad that Dread Arbor isn't in the cube. There should be. It should be legal to Zenith for Arbor. So yeah, I decided to block, which is good. I'm gonna draw two extra cards and Punishing Fire the demon. And we didn't draw the land. If you draw the land, we could have played the Caryatid or the Survival. I guess Survival here, it's good with discarding Maniac Vandal. Let's see what he plays. Solemn Simulacrum. Or I guess I'd rather. I can cast here Unseen Grudge. I mean, not now, I don't care, but it's just something I can do. Here, I really wanted to draw land to cast Zenith for. Ant Master. I think I'm gonna Play Wall of Blossoms and see if I draw land. Then I can play. Yeah, depends on what I draw. Then I can play Sylvan Caryatid if I don't. It's five cards in hand. Draw Bird of Paradise. I can draw two cards. I really want to draw land here. So yeah, just continue. Okay, there was a second island which wasn't ideal, and I keep this, I guess. Nothing to do. Nothing better to do. My hand is pretty stuck here. I don't wanna run the Consecrated Sphinx into 5 mana. Sorry, it's 5 cards in hand. Baneslayer Angel. That is somewhat annoying. And reanimate the Desecration Demon. The lifelink of the Baneslayer will get me have the Punishing Fire in my hand. But still, I don't know what to do. Imperial Recruiter can get me nothing much, actually. Not in a great shape. And the point is that this Wall of Blossom cannot attack with the Baldur's Skull. I can play Imperial Recruiter. Take. I guess it's. Yeah, Master. Then draw two cards. Then. No, this doesn't work. No, I don't think I play Imperial Recruiter here. I can also play Primal Command. And put on top and shuffle the ring. Does help me? No, I don't think it does. Or in the end, I can play. What is that? I really want to draw land and cast this Sphinx. How can I do that? I can play Caryatid and Maniac Vandal. But then my survival isn't that good. Think I need to survival for Atarka and kill the Baneslayer and block the Desecration Demon. So yeah, that is what I'm gonna do. I just need to figure that out. Alright, so I'm gonna play Recruiter and Caryatid. Think I'm gonna just draw two cards off the Recruiter. I will hit land very, very likely. Here I prefer having Glenelandra. I'm gonna draw a land and cast Sylvan Caryatid. And discard. What do I want to discard? Stormbird Dragon. This is protection from dragons. Stormbird Dragon, then. Yeah, I can discard the dragon. I don't even have the double red. Or I can discard the garage. Yeah, sure. So my weapon now is to draw Dragonlord Atarka. And kill the Slayer, block the Desecration. In case this doesn't work, I can still Consecrate Sphinx. Like a keep with Baldur's Skull or some unfair stuff. He has only three cards in hand now. Emeria Angel, after we played the land, that wasn't very smart. Ultimate Prize on the Wall of Blossoms. Cannot. Kozilek wasn't a good draw at all. Here. So. I want to. If I cast Strong Breath, I can cast Strong Breath and Survival. Yeah, I think Strong Breath is a good card here because I can just equip with the Butter Skull and attack. I can take 11 damage here. I also want to grudge the Solemn here. Or I can just play the Sphinx. I think the Sphinx is the most... Yeah, I think the Sphinx is better. He already used a thing there. I mean, Ultimate Price. So I like Consecrate Sphinx and pass with Caryatid to block Solemn Simulacrum, gain life with Punishing Fire, or eventually grudge something. Sorry, gain life, I mean take back the Punishing Fire. Let's see, yeah. He moved to draw, so... Yeah, it's not very experienced with Magical Line. So we get to draw as well. But we aren't in a good shape here. I'm taking... yeah, I'm taking exactly 14. So I need to... I need to tap the Desecration Demon and kill the Solemn. I need to draw Tarka. Tarka as soon as possible. So yeah, I need to tap that. Take 8, go to 6. Let's see. Okay. And he has land. Alright, I did not draw that. I have 5, 6, 7, 8 mana. Don't think I can get... Oh, yeah, I can Zenith for that. Okay, perfect. So, play this, Zenith for the whole amount. Okay, Traggler the Tarka, kill. Oh, I cannot. Yeah, I forgot about that. Cannot kill the Baneslayer actually. But I'm not dead, since it can't. It will just attack me with Baneslayer. Let's see, it's 2 cards in hand. If he somehow deal with the Tarka, I'm gonna lose. But if it doesn't, I will probably keep Tarka with Butter Skull. So yeah, this is an interesting game. He should have played better, of course. And yeah, if he played the land before Mirror Angel, I would be dead this turn, yes. I also was lucky to draw an untapped land that is not this Arid Mesa. Ah no, he has Urberg, so yeah, doesn't matter. Shouldn't crack the fetch land there. So yeah, just waiting for him. Okay, I played Caves of Koilos and Umbira Rites on the Mirror Angel. Once again, why do you do that? And then Umbira Rites on Solemn Simulacrum. That's okay. What I'm gonna do now? Does he attack? Yes. No. He does not attack. Okay. So, here we have 9 mana. We can equip the Atarka, and no, it doesn't work because he has Baneslayer. We can play Primal Command. What do we have in the deck left? Like nothing, okay. So we can play Glenolandra Strombat Go, maybe is the best line. And then equip Strombat. I have 9 mana exactly. Yes. Think this is the best line. Okay. So now the Baneslayer still hit me for f no, I can block it with Glenland, right? Yes. And next turn I can keep the Storm Breath. No, it's still a dragon, so I know, but it has protection from white. Yeah, so Baneslayer cannot block it because I have protection for white, and Storm Breath Dragon cannot block the Baneslayer because it has protection from dragons, which is a pretty funny interaction between those two cards. Alright, here, think of Stabilized. And neck. Okay, what did he draw? Massacre Worm. Do you wish to sacrifice a creature? So, he attacks if. I don't think I wish. No. No, I don't wish. He attack with everyone. And if I block in this way, I'm dead. Wow, he drew very well. No, I don't wanna draw that. Okay, so we get to game two, where we are playing against the black-white mid-range deck. With where balance can be painful against him since he doesn't have any kind of artifact beside Solemn Simulacrum. Or we could have drawn Bonfire. That would be good. Flametongue Cow is good. Yeah, I think everybody but these two cards are good. I'm gonna board in. I think I like boarding in the balance against him. Can probably board out an island. Adding a plains just because we have the Arid Mesa. And we need another card. Maybe Incinerate. Think Incinerate is fine because he has all this big creature that we can deal just by like 2 for 1 ourselves. Like we did with the Punishing Fire. And yeah, we submit this. What a game, though. He did everything to let us win, but then his deck did not want him to lose. This is a great hand, actually. We play turn 2 Awakening Zone, turn 3 Xenagos. There's any reason for me not to lead with the burr? No, there isn't, so I'm gonna lead with the Findarn Elf. If I draw Imperial Recruiter. Yeah. So the only reason to play Bird of Paradise all over Findarn Elf is that if I draw Imperial Recruiter, I wanna play that instead. And I don't wanna give him a life. So I'm gonna play Bird of Paradise first. Okay, let's start. Okay, I might just play two creature rather than the Awakening Zone here. Don't think he has any kind of Wrath of God. And also if he does. Oh, Skull Clamp. So that was the reason why I should have played the Awakening Zone, I guess. I can play Xenagos plus 1, have 5 mana, play Awakening Zone, Skull Clamp draw. Okay, so that's what I'm gonna do. Let's see. Plus one. Add three green. Place cool clamp. Kill the Findorn. Bonfire right there. And play the Awakening Zone. Let's see if he has Oblivion Ring another time. Even if he does, I mean, I'm in a commanding position. I think you should take the school clamp this time, not the Awakening Zone. Let's see. Hero's Downfall on Xenagos. It's okay. Yes, I do. And just gonna keep the Drazi spawn. Drew balance, which isn't very balanced right now. Yeah. So I think I'm gonna kill my own bird right now. I really have nothing to do with all this mana. And just gonna play this on master. I think with library, why not? And yeah, I'm master of the fells. Solemn Simulacrum for him. And now my plan is just to draw two cards first. Then I think I can draw a card of two library. And yes, use it. So just gonna draw a card of library. No, sorry, draw two cards. Then play land, draw four library. I wanna do all the card advantage as possible. This matchup is all about that. So just draw a card. And then I can Zenith. I think I'm gonna save Zenith for Atarka. So I'm just gonna equip the wolf and then pass. And my Antmaster is gonna flip. Did I play land? See, probably I shouldn't even attack here, because if he blocks, I lose the Antmaster ability, and I'm gonna discard like three cards. Yeah, probably this attack is bad. I should not attack here. He chose to block, which is the right choice. Let's see, I drop Prima Command, that doesn't help me at all, and I'm gonna discard, oh yeah, I should have a keep, whatever. I'm gonna discard, I think, three lands. Yeah. Antmaster flips and will not be difficult for him to flip again. For him to flip again on the other side. Kinda notice that I'm very low on time respect to him. So I'm glad it's taking some time doing nothing. My sixth land, and I think a big fight is gonna come. It's just another end. Okay, I guess this didn't work. Should draw in upkeep maybe with Aloha. No, I don't think so. I can still play land and draw from Labyrinth Alexandria. Yeah, draw a card. I can I can put a land on top and yeah, do this. Probably first I draw two cards. And then we see. Okay. Stormbred Dragon, yeah, I'm gonna play this. I need some actions. And this Stormbred is fine doing that. Okay, gonna discard. Guess it's a forest. And I think balance is now time to discard it. Yeah. I don't need it anymore. You may range your land this time. Okay. I can cast a Tarka next turn. Oblivion Ring. The Awakening Zone. Alright. Oh, I drew a Tarka. Actually, so I can tap the Loa to draw a card. Yes. And yeah. Cannot discard the Kozilek, but I guess I'm not gonna cast it. Necromancy, what? Okay. Guess if he destroyed this and then Necromancy back, killing the Stormbird would be. No, I can still Primal Command the Necromancy, but yeah. Wall of Omens. What if I bonfire for 1, 2, 3, 4? Is he dead? Yeah, I think he does. Yes, he's dead now. So I'm just gonna bonfire him for. I think it's 4. Okay. Alright, now we go on to game 3 with a bit minutes in late, but I hope this matchup is favorable for us since we do a lot of card advantage and he kind of does nothing until late game where we're supposed to went already big with our card advantage. Alright, so I don't know if this balance is still good. Didn't prove to be very good, actually, this game, but can be a card that can get me out of some situations. And since I don't think I have many options, I mean, this Chandra is medium. Regrow. Yeah, regrow. I don't know. Yeah, I think I prefer regrow than the Chandra. Sorry, then the Chandra, then the balance. What land I don't want? Think I don't want the island actually. The island I think is pretty bad. Deck build choice. I'm fine with one more forest. I cannot take Mulligan for not having forest. Maybe since Sense Divine in top can help us better than the regrow. Yeah, let's try the Sense Divine in top. Alright. We draw a hand with Lever of Alexandria. That should be very good against a mid-range deck. I mean, should be very good against everybody, but Lotus Bloom suspended. Okay. All right. Yes, to save time and just draw a card and F8. And the next turn. I think I can play Zenith for one and don't draw card actually. Yeah. Like it more. Taking the bird. I don't have double blue. So that can be something. And let's see. Okay, ultimate price and nothing. All right, I drew a pretty good card. I'm just gonna draw a card and cast Sylvan Caryatid. Now he's gonna get nasty with his Lotus Bloom. I hope not to. I hope not to see a big fatty. I prefer a non-creature permanent to shuffle back in the opponent deck. Benji. Benji came down. What I'm gonna do is just drawing how do I get out of that? Survival into Consecrated Sphinx is the answer. But I don't have creature yet. I can play. So I play land. Yeah, probably Surf of Frost was better. Draw card. Punishing Fire doesn't work. And then I can. Yeah, the dream was to draw. I think I'm gonna play Xenagos just to let him attack this and gain a turn. Where it's very important for me to get turns where I draw like creature to discard for the survival or just bonfire. Bonfire now doesn't do it. No, yeah, it does because you have Punishing Fire. So yeah, Leonin Relic Warden, you can have that. Xenagos is down. And they drew Glenolander Archmage. Which is not very. I don't really want to discard that. I can also play Sulphur Falls. Draw card. Play Glenolandra Pass. I can also attack since the Caryatid will be blocked by the Lunar Relic Warden will be blocked by the Caryatid. He attacks, I don't want to block with the Glenolandra. Guess I have the Recursion Punishing Fire Grove. Shouldn't probably let this trade, I don't know. Let's see. Next turn, I mean, I'm gonna keep drawing cards off the library. And yeah, if his only threat is Baneslayer, I think I can be able to raise that eventually. Even with the Storm Breath or like Baldur's Call. Or yeah, the rest of the deck, basically. Alright, so the block resolved. And we're gonna pass. And now our Consecrated Sphinx is protected from the Glenolandra. Next turn, I will deploy the survival. End of turn. Oh, I can Brain Maggot. Okay, I have Punishing Fire for that. And if he takes it, I mean, he takes it. I don't really care a lot. And then, as I said, I will play Survival. I can play Survival Recruiter. Took Awakening Zone. Doesn't seem the best choice, but Okay, take five. Pass. My turn. All right. So I will draw a card of library, as I always do. Can draw the consequence things. No, I did not. So play the survival this way. Then cast a forest and just guess attack with the Glenolandra. And then end of turn I will exchange the recruiter for the Consecrated Sphinx and then cast it. I could also have played Steam Vents tapped to have more blue mana next turn, but I guess I can also take two life, two damage here. Think I should also play the Grove to get back the punishing in the end of turn, but I guess having hit, since he hit me with the Baneslayer, I can do that as well. But I don't think I do. So what is this? Banisher Priest. All right. So yes, this resolve. And what do you take? Glenolandra. That is fine for me. Now he attack me with the Baneslayer. I'm gonna Punishing Fire the priest. And then get back it since he gained life. All right, now activate survival. And take the, where is it? Consecrate Sphinx. Okay. Now, think I just played this. Yeah, should have. No, I don't think I should have drawn for a library. Prefer doing this way. Attack for two, then cast a Sphinx, then leave mana on tap for either. Yeah, I think I leave Caryatid on tap. And yeah, Punishing Fire, mana up. He's gaining a lot of life, so maybe it will be difficult for me to race, even if I'm in a very. Oh yeah, Kozilek will close this game. Forgot about Daddy Kozilek in my deck. Shouldn't tap the library because now I go to up to seven. Yeah, those are small mistake that you happen to do in the queue because of the situation aren't very doesn't happen many time. Okay. So what now? Yeah, I wanna draw a creature for casting Kozilek soon. Still attack me. I can also double block here. No, it doesn't. Okay, so I have eight cards. I will play Mox Ruby, draw a card. Then even I can cast Primal Command, bounce a swamp, take a creature, whatever it is. Kozilek. Okay, so put target non-permanent target. Okay. This one. All right, take Kozilek. And yeah, pass. Oh, no, I didn't play land yet. So yeah, pass. And not attack. You may draw two land, two cards. Yes, I do. In case, so reanimate the Banisher Priest. I need to counter that. And then I can also discard Kozilek, Necromancy. Okay. Yeah, I probably shouldn't counter that since I can. Can just punish and fire it. Yeah. Should have just let it resolve. I need one man. Okay. See, I'm not gonna drawing any more cards of the Consecrated Sphinx and just F6ing very fast with the Kozilek. Shouldn't yeah, shouldn't use the Glenalandra of that. But I mean the clock always hurting me every time I play a magical line. No, I do not want to draw. Okay. I think now I just play very fast and attack, cast Atarka. Kill is stuff. I don't even know if I want to cast Atarka. I think I just attack twice. Or rather, three times. Yeah, I should have cast Atarka first. No, I need to cast Atarka because might not be able to have three turns. I don't know. I'm very slow. My connection is low. And everything. So, yeah, it's gonna sacrificing those. So, my Atarka doesn't work anymore. Yeah, this was a misplay. Oh, I don't want to draw two cards. And okay. What? Okay, I think I play random stuff now. No, I don't want to cast this. So just, yeah, F6 and F6 again. F6 attack with all. And yeah, this should be game. So yeah, this game was kind of fun. No, I don't want to draw cards. All right, so we'll be back for second match in very early. Yeah.